Hubert, tell us what this garden is really all about.
Oh, much things. So I believe it's the expression of my dream. A dream that it's possible to make the paradise on the earth. I was every time thinking, but where is the heaven? But the earth is in the heaven. So why not express that? And so I was making it 20 years ago, making all this energy, and to try to understand the different levels of energy, and I was beginning with the nature, with plants, and also professional. I was a gardener, and so I began to feel in my work to feel how plants makes reaction with the people, how plants are in reaction with the place they are planted.
So in other words, that it's not just a question of you put them in the earth and they grow.
No, it is not. I like this plant that I can see very good how lovely this plant. No, it's another way. I will go to, I had the plant, and I'm feeling the place, and I'm feeling how the plant makes a reaction with this place. And also with me, but he's speaking to me. And then I'm going to different places and feeling where he is happy.
So this garden has really been, you felt the way it should be, rather than you haven't sat and designed it.
No, you felt it.
I believe you felt very strongly that the earth had an energy line, that you then made the main path along there?
I felt that the energies in the yard is not our right, but go with curves and with up and downs. And that's the problem, for example, in the agriculture we make today. All is in lines projected by the mind, and to not correspond with the energy. And so we make the plants so becomes less strong. She attracts illness because that we are not in the exact energy.
So just like people and animals feel comfortable in certain situations, things, you have found a way to put all the plants in their right place. Mm-hmm. Now, this, I think, is there's something even behind this as a principle. You've realized a dream. Everyone can realize a dream, and in fact it's not so much even realize a dream, but to make concrete something which is inside ourselves and to bring it out.
I believe that the big problem of the people living on the world is that the thing they are is isolated from the whole.
Yes.
And that it's like she needs love and to don't receive them. When we are at like separate, we are thinking that we are separated, and the experience of the garden is just like throw the plants, discover how she are connected with the whole. And it was like the reflection myself. I feel me sometimes so isolated of the rest of the world. Why did not understand the people what I'm doing, what I'm feeling? And that is the reason is that we are in the mind of, with our conditioning, so separated of the rest that we're not going to really communicate. And that this communication with the nature is basically to discover how we can communicate with each other. I had a dream to make possible to be understood with more people, to be more in union with our people. That I believe that's the peace. That's peace. When we are in harmony, we have peace. And there is so much conflict that it is anyway we have to find a way to cut this conflicts that exist. And I was searching the way, and I believe the nature indicates me how to come to that.
Would you also say that part of the way you're doing this is that you're bringing into the creation of a garden an energy which is more than a physical energy, yeah. Shall we say? You're bringing in that in. But this is also a kind of demonstration of how, in order to harmonize our own lives, we bring in a greater energy into our ordinary life.
Mm. By consciousness.
Through consciousness. Now, at the beginning I said that this was like, it's like an astral garden. We use the word astral. An astral energy is a finer energy.
I believe it's not only astral, it's also very physically. Okay. Physically, astral and more. But there are other dimensions than only astrological levels.
Astral levels.
I believe there are spiritual levels in it.
So, yeah. And these spiritual and astral and whatever, they come down into the physical level now?
Yes. I believe but the force of what we are feeling here and why we are feeling well when you're coming here is the reason that all these different levels are in harmony together. We are going in what we can realize of our paradise on the most highest level we can imagine. It's a divine lesson of creating things. It's pure creation on that level. And it's to be without conditioning and express pure energy of love. And what you are doing is connect you with all what can be imagined, all the possibilities. But you are realizing that. And I believe that is wonderful. That's like miraculous. What I say, or what I can communicate with the people, it's real. It's experimented and not only a thing I was dreaming of, a theory I was making with my mind. It makes part of my life. Yeah, it's to try to connect and to understand what is happening on this moment and transform it in connection with all.
So how can I, for myself, if you like, work in the same way? I mean, maybe I don't create a garden, but can I do something else whereby I actually experience this obvious power?
In your possibilities you have, make film or make in your work, it's to try express you in an authentic way, searching the connection with all. Not I'm more strong, I have an objective like to make money. No, I will express really what I feeling and what is authentic and it's in harmony with myself and also in harmony with the other. And then you begin to play. I believe the energy, the divine energy is play first of all. To enjoying what you do. That's an expression of love. But what is not love is make conflict. Yeah. Is opposite of that. When you learn to express your authentic, you are playing on the same time. You let go, flow the energy and you in the communication with your environment. And that is authentic. And that is expression of love. But it's not a mental projection of a thing. It's to be so and the laws of the science are so. No, that's not alive. That's only cause-effect in certain circumstances. But when water is cooking now on 100 degrees, when the situation is changing, the water will not be not cooking on 100 degrees. Yeah. So it's all relative to that. The our divine nature is not relative, it's absolutely expression in communication with the all. And not only words, not only thinking and concepts, is real, express and live directly in your environment.